I would like to thank the organizers of this symposium, Dr. Cyril Kendall and John Seven Piper, for inviting me to this very nice congress held in this always friendly city of Toronto. Oops. Okay. So here you have my potential conflict of interest. My institution has received some funding for research from the ANC. And also part of this, the results that I will show you were funded by American Pistachios Growers and Paramore Farm. But anyway, all of them have been already published, so they were submitted to a peer review. I think it's not necessary to convince anybody in this forum that type 2 diabetes is one of the major public burden, global burden worldwide. Because its prevalence, the incidence, and also because the economic cost, the associated economic cost. And probably for the reason, any strategy focused on both the prevention and the management of this pathology will be welcome. Some years ago, Mediterranean diet emerged as a healthy dietary pattern, but not only for cardiovascular outcomes, but also for type 2 diabetes, as in fact has been widely discussed this morning in this same room. So from the PREDIMED study, what we observed was that those subjects following a Mediterranean diet supplemented with olive oil or a Mediterranean diet supplemented with nut had a lower risk to develop type 2 diabetes. But I'm not talking again about a Mediterranean diet. I only focus my next 15 minutes, more or less, in a key food from the Mediterranean pyramid. I'm talking about nuts. Why nuts? Well, as everybody knows, nuts are energy-dense foods. Mostly of them are made of fatty acids, but most of the fatty acids that nuts contain are polyunsaturated fatty acids and monounsaturated fatty acids. So are we talking about healthy fatty acids? There was a discussion this morning about this. But also nuts has a matrix of mineral components, not less important. I'm talking about antioxidants, polyphenols, also fiber. So although we don't know now yet the exact mechanism by which this components of nuts could play a role in diabetes, we suggest that some of them, for example, magnesium, we know that because has been already demonstrated by other authors, that all of, some of them can play a role regulating postprandial glucose clearance or improving pancreatic secretion or also decreasing insulin resistance. But what are the observational studies telling us? So if we go back to the PREDIMED trial, in a cross-sectional assessment, we demonstrate in our group that those subjects who intake more than 3 servings per week of nuts had a higher prevalence of type 2 diabetes. However, we failed to find a higher prevalence of high fasting plasma glucose, taking into account the cut-off values used by the definition of metabolic syndrome. But what's going on with the longitudinal studies? So in contrast to those reported before by Dr. Yi Bao regarding cardiovascular outcomes, the evidence in type 2 diabetes are less clear and a little bit inconclusive. So from all the studies, whereas 3 of them reported a negative association between nut consumption and the incidence of type 2 diabetes, the other 2 didn't report any significant association or even a significant higher risk to develop type 2 diabetes. So looking at this, these results, a question is coming to my mind. So maybe there is a difference between men and women? Because in NASA's Health Study 1, in the NASA's Health Study 2, they found significant association. Anyway, last year, in 2014, A series of meta-analyses were published in the same journal, in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition. And if we have a look to the results, are really interesting, because whereas the first one couldn't find any significant relationship between nut consumption and the incidence of type 2 diabetes, the second one showed a non-significant trend to a beneficial role of nuts, and the third one significantly demonstrated that there was a relationship, a prevention, regarding nuts on type 2 diabetes. More recently, 2 months ago, in March 2015, if I'm not wrong, there is another publication regarding the relationship between nuts and the effect of nuts on the incidence of type 2 diabetes. This was conducted in the EPIC cohort, and once again, they couldn't find, I'm not sure if I have a pointer here, they couldn't find any significant association. There was a trend, but they couldn't find any significant association between nut consumption and SIDS, in this case, and the incidence of type 2 diabetes. So, what are the clinical trials are telling us? So, have a look. We can divide clinical trials in clinical trials at short term and clinical trials at long term. What happened at short term? What's going on with the acute feeding clinical trials? We have different studies conducted in different type of subjects, healthy or type 2 diabetes, at different age, and giving different type of nuts. But all of them agreed in a lowering effect of nuts, lowering glucose and insulin lowering effect of nuts. So that's good. But what happened with the longitudinal, with the middle term or long term clinical trials? 5 years ago, we conducted a study on this issue in our group. We designed a parallel study conducted in metabolic syndrome. So 50 subjects who were randomly allocated to a diet, including a mix of walnuts, hazelnuts, and almonds, and another group free of nuts. And what we found at the end of the follow-up, after 12 weeks of intervention, what we found was a significant reduction in the nut diet group, a significant reduction of insulin and HOMA insulin resistance. So, looking at the results, we could say that nuts are working in the decrease of insulin and the improvement of insulin resistance. But there are, of course, other studies in the literature. I left some of them, not too much, but some of them are not in this table. If we have a look again, we have different studies, again, of course, with different design, crossover, or sometimes parallel studies, conducted on different populations, on different subjects. Some of them were healthy, obese, or type 2 diabetes, or even pre-diabetic subjects, with a length of coming from 4 weeks to, I don't remember the longest, but maybe 60 weeks, in different number of subjects, giving different type of nuts and leading different type of results. So whereas some of them couldn't find any effect, any beneficial effect, not deleterious as well, any beneficial effect of nuts on glucose and insulin metabolism, others reported a down lowering glucose and insulin effect of nuts. In the best of my knowledge, at the moment, there is only one published meta-analysis of clinical trials trying to assess the effect of nuts on diabetes. In this case, it's in the control of diabetes. This study was conducted here in Toronto, led by Dr. Cyril Kendall and also John Sieben Piper. And if you have a look to this graph, what we can see is that the total, nuts had provokes a decrease in hemoglobin A1C, meaning that a better improvement of type 2 diabetes. They also found a significant decrease of glucose, fasting glucose plasma levels, and a non-significant trend to a lower, a decrease of insulin plasma levels. And at least in my knowledge, there is nothing else relating nuts and type 2 diabetes or glucose and insulin metabolism. Now I'm moving to a one study, the last study that we conducted in our unit on this issue. But we were aware about not the treatment of diabetes, but probably the prevention of diabetes. As you know, it's quite difficult to conduct a study on the prevention of any disease. So we were interested in, when diabetes is knocking our door, so in the pre-diabetic status. As you know, pre-diabetes status is also a metabolic derangement, and it's maybe worse than type 2 diabetes because it's a silent abnormality. So you don't know if you are or not pre-diabetic. You need a biochemical test, but you know if you are or not diabetes. And also the prevalence of pre-diabetes, the people who knows about this issue, say that it's about 900 million people. So much more, three times more than diabetic subjects. So our idea was to know if it's possible to reverse this pre-diabetic stage, thinking about if it's possible to prevent type 2 diabetes. So we designed a crossover feeding clinical trials of 4 months in each arm, conducted in 54 pre-diabetic subjects, giving them by free, in this case, pistachio. 57 grams of pistachio per day during 4 months. It's quite hard to do, but the people agreed to participate. So here you have the characteristics of diet, and I show you the most interesting results. Talking about plasma glucose, plasma insulin, and home insulin resistance, what we found? So we found that in the pistachio arm, subjects significantly decrease plasma glucose, plasma insulin, and home insulin resistance. So there was an improvement in the pre-diabetic state. Also, we found a non-significant improvement of hemoglobin A1C. The other question that came to our mind was, what are the mechanisms, the molecular mechanisms, that could explain these findings? And we focus our interest in lymphocytes. Why lymphocytes? Because probably are one of the main triggers of inflammation. And as is widely accepted worldwide, is that type 2 diabetes is a chronic inflammatory status, as obesity use or cardiovascular disease is as well. So we analyze at cellular level, we analyze the expression of different genes involved in glucose and insulin metabolism. For example, the gene of GLUT4 transporter, AL6 in this case is an inflammatory gene, and resistin. And what we found was a significant differences between, again, those subjects taking pistachio daily in comparison to those subjects free of nuts. And these results were in line to those obtained when we analyzed the glucose uptake at cellular levels. So lymphocytes, in this case, had, after pistachio intervention, had a significant decrease in the consumption of glucose. What it means is that these lymphocytes were less hyperreactive, so they were less pro-inflammatory. And just to finish my session today, probably most of you agree with me if we say that regular consumption of nuts in general could have an important glucose and insulin lowering effect, especially a short term, but probably also we have some evidences at middle and long term. But I hope you agree as well that we need large, long term, high quality clinical trials in order to better understand the real role of nuts in the prevention of type 2 diabetes. And thank you very much for your attention.